So in almost every physics problem, it's going to be really important to draw a picture of the situation before you start trying to solve it, because it'll give you a much better understanding of what's actually going on. So in this case, we have a cart of mass, big M, with a man of mass, little m, standing on top of it. And both of them are moving to the right with speed vi, standing for v initial. And we're actually going to define the right direction to be positive. And in this case, we also have an after. So immediately as the problem starts, the man starts running to the left with speed vr, standing for v relative, which is velocity relative to the block. And the block is, of course, still moving with some velocity big V. And so what's important to note about this is that VR is not the man's absolute velocity. It's simply his speed in the moving reference frame of the cart, itself. So we don't actually know yet what his absolute velocity is. And this big V right here is the value that we're trying to solve for. So the first thing that it's important to note is that the man and the block form an isolated system. So there are no net external forces acting upon the man-block system, which means that we can say that momentum is conserved and that Pi equals Pf. So first we're going to calculate the momentum in the first situation. So this is Pi, and all we have to do for this is we add their masses together and then multiply by the velocity, because they're both moving together. So that's going to be big M plus little m times Vi. Now Pf is a little bit more complicated, because remember, we don't know what his velocity is in an inertial reference frame. So here, all we need to do is we take big M times big V for the cart, and then for the man, it's going to be a little bit more complicated. So he's going to be little m, and then we take the velocity of the reference frame, and we have to subtract out the velocity, we have to add in the velocity of the, his relative velocity to the cart. And the reason we're adding this is because they're vector quantities. And so in the end, this is going to end up actually being negative, because his velocity is in the leftward direction, and we can find positive to be to the right. But since it's a velocity, we need to add it together. So now we can set the two of these equal to each other, and we can pull out this little m times vr term so that we can isolate the big V and solve for that later. So what that's going to give us is big M plus little m times big V equals big M plus little m times vi. And then we subtract this out. So this is going to be negative little m times vr. And now we can divide out the big M plus little m, and that's going to give us big V equals vi, and these terms cancel, minus little m over big M plus little m times vr. And now we can start to plug in all of the values that we know. So in the problem statement, we're given that vi equals 5.0 meters per second, and that's going to be times x hat because it's moving to the right. Little m equals 80 kilograms. Big M equals 100 kilograms. And VR, which is his velocity relative to the cart, is going to be negative 10 meters per second x hat. And remember, the reason it's negative is because he's moving to the left instead of the right. Now, plugging all of these values in, we're going to get 5 meters per second minus 80 kilograms over 180 kilograms times negative 10 meters per second. And all of this is going to be times x hat. And if we solve this out doing all of this algebra, we're going to end up with 85 over 9 meters per second x hat. So that's the final velocity of the cart moving to the right.